gosh darn, it's good to see artillery here again. Now here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close.
Stay safe, people.
That's what the smoke grenades are for. Toss one of those at the bad guys. If we have artillery in range, we'll confirm over the radio and target our fire on your smoke. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to radio freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
Stay safe, people.
Minutemen, right? always happy to help. What did you need?
A pack of feral ghouls has holed up nearby, and some of them have started wandering out lately. If more of them start wandering out this way, we may be overrun. We need someone to clear them out.
I'm on it. It's as good as done.
I'll be glad to have them gone.
All the resources they've got, Brotherhood could do a lot of good. Shame they want to wipe out my kind instead.
Fist was weak.
I gotta hand it to you, General. You really turned things around for the Minutemen. I never thought I'd see the day that the Minutemen have artillery support again. We should see about building them at all our settlements to expand our coverage. And Ronnie Shaw returns. She's something else, isn't she?
What do you think of her?
People like her. She comes across pretty hard-ass. But she's one of the good ones. I'd heard stories about her from the old-timers, but I didn't know she was still around. The fact that she's come back to the Minutemen means we must be doing something right. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Humans all look funny. So much work. Why don't you more buy?
Need something? Shoot. Pretty simple arrangement.
So, you ready to get this show on the road?
Let's do it.
Done.
It's an honor, sir, to know that the beloved mayor of Good Neighbor is taking my place.
Pleasure, Codsworth. Keep it real.
Hell of a load you're carrying.
Hey, Cleo.
I've got a weapon here for every situation. Hunting, protection, cold-blooded murder, hot-blooded murder.
Let's see what you got.
Murder and mayhem at a discount.
You got. Not seeing a way to get there.
Over here.
Can't get to that. That's out of my reach, brother.
Remember the last time I had clean fingernails?
Huh?
Hey.
I can do that.
Heads up.
Got my attention.
Move here.
Good as done. You got it. Where I'm standing, I ain't getting there.
Here.
Sure.
Go check that out. Heads up.
Shoot. Good as done.
I'll try to make myself useful. No one wants to see a grown man feeling sorry for himself.
Raiders thought we were easy pickings. We showed them different.
I just want to trade a few things.
Go ahead.
protect and serve.
Clear out those ghouls?
Took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did? That's great news.
I just want to trade a few things.
Okay.
we make a hell of a team.
I cleared out the ghouls that were giving that settlement trouble.
Glad to hear it, General. It's hard enough out here without people having to worry about ghouls in their backyard.
Better than this.
all alone.
Thank you. still in the engagement zone.
Thank you.
Thank you. This should send a message to the gunners to stay off my back.
You aren't afraid the gunners will retaliate?
The way these lunatics act, you'd think they would. But I know better. With the gunners, it's always about the bottom line. And they just lost this entire way station, and that cost them big. Besides, they have no way of knowing I was involved. Anyway, I guess I owe you a favor now. After all, you hired me, but I'm the one that dragged you out here.
You don't owe me. You clearly needed the help.
Sure, but I like everything to remain nice and even. And you're one up on me. Tell you what, I'm going to give you back the caps you paid me in Good Neighbor. I'll still stick with you because that was part of the original deal, but now we're even. There you go. And I guess we're done here. Lead on, boss.
You in the spotlight, me in the shadows. Lookout world.
Protecting people from themselves. The oldest excuse of any tyrant.
Need something?
Ah, my favorite meat shield.
Strong.
What now?
I've gotten word about a settlement that's been threatened by raiders. I'll mark it on your map. Go find out what they need. We could use more settlements supporting our cause.
Steelmen are hard outside, but soft inside.
It's a fun drive from working with the gunners. Glad that's behind me.
Steelmen are work.
Look alive.
Hey, Hancock.
Hey, mind if we talk now?
Of course. What's up?
Look, I needed to mention. Just you taking care of Bobby. I ain't proud of having to put you through that. That sort of dictatorial shit ain't usually my style.
You seem awfully torn up over Bobby. Was there something between you?
Nah, nothing like that. I just hate seeing guys like me use their sway to do that kind of harm. Hell, that sort of bull's the whole reason I became mayor in the first place. Some ass named Vic ran the town for I don't know how long before that. Guy was scum. Used us drifters like his own personal piggy bank. He had this goon squad he'd use to keep people in line. Every so often he'd let them off the leash, go blow off some steam on the populace at large. Folks with homes could lock their doors, but us drifters, we got it bad. There was one night, some drifter said something to them. They cracked him open like a can of cram on the pavement. And we all just stood there, did nothing.
You can't blame yourself. Sounds like you were outmatched. Probably would have killed you too.
You're right. But it was still spineless. I felt like less than nothing. Afterwards, I got so high, I blacked out completely. When I finally came to, I was on the floor of the old state house, right in front of the clothes of John Hancock. John Hancock, first American hoodlum and defender of the people. I might have still been high, but those clothes spoke to me, told me what I needed to do. I smashed the case, put him on, started a new life as Hancock. After that, I went clean for a bit, got organized, convinced Cleo to loan me some hardware, got a crew of drifters together and headed out into the ruins, started training. Next time Vic's boys went on their tear, we'd be ready for them.
The fact that you're standing here and Vic isn't would suggest things went well?
Oh, yeah. So, the night of, we all got loaded, let Vic's boys get good and hammered, and burst from the windows and rooftops where we'd been hiding. They never even saw it coming. We didn't have to fire a shot. We didn't have to, but we sure fucking did. It was a massacre. Once we'd mopped up, we strolled right into Vic's quarters in the state house, wrapped a rope around his neck, and threw him off the balcony. And there I am. Gun in hand, draped in Hancock's duds, looking at all the people of Good Neighbor assembled below. I had to say something. That first time I said them, they didn't even feel like my words. Of the people, for the people, was my inaugural address. Became Mayor Hancock of Good Neighbor that day. And from then on, I vowed I'd never stand by and watch. Ever again.
And you're never gonna have to. We'll take care of the Commonwealth together.
Good. I just hope you get where I was coming from. I ain't out to bring harm to anyone that didn't earn it. Though I'm getting the distinct idea you got the same plan. Well, you probably heard enough of me running my mouth for one day. Wanna get moving?
Hancock.
Look who it is. We heading out again?
Let's do it.
Done. Sorry, Pooch. Stay. Not sure how much
hey.
This fresh air. Air and sunshine I can handle. Gotta be a bar around here somewhere.
Thank you.
What is this place?
This is Cabot House, like it says on the sign. And if you don't know what that is, you're in the wrong place. You should leave before you get yourself in trouble.
Let me in. Edward Deegan asked me to come here.
Oh, it's you. Good. Come on in.
Lead on.
Jack, the new guy is here.
One moment. I just have to...
He'll be right with us.
Oh, damn. Clearly, I'll need to adjust the mixture.
Hello. Welcome to Cabot House. I'm Jack Cabot.
Edward said you needed to talk to me before he hired me?
Yes. Edward finds it tiresome, but I always like to know personally everyone who works for me. Please, have a seat. How about a drink?
Edward, the good bourbon, eh?
Please, have a seat.
People can't actually live here, right?
Now, before we get down to business, I have a question I like to ask all my new employees.
Is this really the time?
Don't interrupt, Edward. The question is this. Do you believe there is other intelligent life in the universe?
The universe is a big place. Anything could be out there.
Wonderful. Most people's minds are too narrow to admit the possibilities of an infinite universe. But I'm not talking about flying saucers and little green men. I'm talking about the hidden history of our planet. The very origins of human civilization. Ancient powers that modern science, even at its pinnacle, could barely begin to comprehend.
That's really interesting.
Stranger things have turned out to be true.
I'm glad to hear you say that. It's become my life's work. My approach is to combine a rigorous scientific method while keeping an absolutely open mind. So much has been closed off to us simply because people assumed they already knew the answers. My father excavated a city in the Rub al-Khali in Arabia, which he dated to more than 4,000 years before the rise of any known human civilization. The structures and artifacts were strange, disturbing even, clearly not constructed for or by humans. I've spent my life trying to decipher what he uncovered.
Jack, can I tell him what I need him to do?
I'm sorry, Edward. I just get carried away sometimes. You're sending him to look for the missing shipment?
Yeah.
Well then, I'd better leave you to it. We'll talk more about this some other time, when things are less rushed. It isn't important now. Welcome to the family.
Okay, you're officially hired. Congratulations.
I'm ready to get to work.
Good. That's part of the job, by the way. It's best to keep an open mind. Jack may be eccentric, but he's definitely not crazy. The job I got for you is simple. Jack owns a facility north of the city. There's an important package that went missing between there and here. I need you to track it down and bring it back to me. Any questions?
You haven't told me half of what I need to know.
Keep your shirt on. I'm getting to it. You should start at Parsons State Insane Asylum. Don't let the name spook you. It's just a secure building that we're using. We think the courier got ambushed as he was leaving the place. The guards heard gunfire in the distance, but we don't know exactly what happened. Check in with Maria at Parsons. She's in charge of the security force there. She can point you in the right direction. You all set then?
Yep, I'll see you soon with the package.
Good luck. Don't get killed on your first job.
Hey, Edward.
What is it?
Why does Jack have people guarding an old insane asylum?
I don't mind you asking questions. As long as you don't mind me not answering them. If it was important to what I was asking you to do, I'd tell you. In this case, it isn't. Are we good here?
How did this package go missing?
The courier got there and picked up the package just fine, but never got back here. Could be simple bad luck, or it could be a deliberate ambush. That's why I'm sending you. It's important that you recover the missing package. You all set then?
What's this missing package I'm looking for?
It's a metal case holding vials of serum. You don't need to worry about what it is. Jack needs it for his research. That's all you need to know. Anything else?
Nothing else.
Okay. They're expecting you over at Parsons, so you'd better get going.
Ah, hello.
Hi.
What?
I was intrigued by your theory about an ancient alien civilization.
Actually, it was my father's theory. Now proven beyond doubt, although only to me, unfortunately. There aren't many archaeology journals publishing these days.
You have proof.
Enough to satisfy me. He only made a single expedition to the Lost City, but he brought back enough to show beyond a doubt that the city he found wasn't made by or for human beings. Millennia older than the earliest human civilizations, but with technology that seems to have surpassed our own. And yet, everything about it is strange, disturbing geometries, tools not made for human hands, carvings that hint at dimensions beyond our own.
What was your father's theory?
He believed that all of the earliest human civilizations shared some common parent that was unknown to history. Think of Atlantis. The myth of an advanced civilization destroyed by a cataclysm is shared by many widely separated ancient cultures. Eventually, he found what he was looking for. A lost city, buried beneath the sands of the empty quarter of the Arabian desert.
You said your father found a lost city?
Yes. He spent years looking, and was widely ridiculed by the so-called experts. I'm ashamed to say even I doubted him. But in the end, he found it. A lost city, buried in the sands of the Rub al-Khali, the empty quarter of Arabia.
I wanted to ask you about something else.
All right.
What's going on at that old insane asylum?
I carry out some of my research there. That's all you need to know.
The more I know, the better I'll be at my job.
I'm sorry, but it really is private family business. Any more questions?
Quite a place you've got here. Amazing that it survived the war.
Thank you. I try not to take it for granted. We were definitely more fortunate than most. It hasn't been easy keeping it up to pre-war standards, but we do what we can. Are we done?
How'd your father manage to travel to Arabia with the world blown to hell?
Ah, well, that was before the war, when he was a young man.
Come on. The war was 200 years ago.
You know your history. Most people don't grasp how long ago the war really was. It is an unusual situation, but... well, it's a private family matter. That's no concern of yours. Are we done?
Quite a place you've got here. Amazing that it survived the war.
Thank you. I try not to take it for granted. We were definitely more fortunate than most. It hasn't been easy keeping it up to pre-war standards, but we do what we can. Are we done?
I've got to get going.
All right.
The only way you get old in this job is assume everyone's out to kill you.
Excuse me.
Make a move,
spend
and
your
I'll
caps,
end you
and I'll make it
there.
All better.
Could use some supplies, actually.
I got loads of stim packs, chems, you name it.
Don't eye the Brahmin if you got any sense.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
Hey there.
Hey, at least it's honest work. Wiseman's in charge here.
We're in some real trouble here. I hope you can help.
Excuse me.
I don't know what we're going to do.
Make yourself at home, friend. You look like...
Welcome to the Slough. We're the only tarberry bog in the Commonwealth. So what do you think of the place?
Looks fine, I guess. I wouldn't really know.
Yeah, I didn't think you had the look of a farmer about you. More the city type, I'd say. But with that smooth, clean skin. You probably noticed it's only ghouls around here. I used to live in Diamond City, until that rat bastard mayor threw me and all the other ghouls out. I decided that we ghouls should have a place where we could feel welcome, and that's mainly why I started up this farm.
Why did the mayor throw you out?
We're ugly. We turn feral and kill people. We give the kids nightmares. All the usual stuff we get from you smooth skins. Now, it's true that there was one incident in Diamond City where a ghoul turned feral and someone got hurt. But I ask you this. How many humans have suddenly turned violent and killed someone? I've seen it more times than I care to admit. What if this place could be more than just a refuge for ghouls who aren't welcome elsewhere? What if it could also be an example of what we can do when we put our minds to something and work together? We want this to be a place that everyone looks forward to visiting, with smiling faces, good bargains, and great produce. Maybe we could make people take a second look, you know? Maybe then they'd see that we're not monsters.
Anything I can do to help?
As a matter of fact, there is. We can't sell tarberries without traders. And trade caravans need safe roads. There's a gang of super mutants that's been preying on anyone who comes near their turf, including traders. It'd be a great help to us if you could take care of those brutes once and for all.
Do you know where they're coming from?
We have a pretty good idea. I hope you can find them and wipe them out.
Well, ain't that clever?
Let's see.
nice.
Good on you.
Brotherhood ain't real fond of the Just don't bring any trouble down on us.
This place is off limits. You'd best not.
What is this place?
It's nothing to do with you, that's for sure. Now, I told you to get moving.
Edward Deegan sent me. I'm looking for a missing package.
Oh, you're the new guy. So this package... pretty sure we know where it is. The guys that shot Ben are holed up in the Parsons Creamery, just north of here.
Who are these guys? Raiders?
Sure. Assholes with guns. Though it's weird that they're still hanging around so close. Kinda like they're scouting this place or something. I don't like it. I'm glad you're gonna finally get rid of them. What do you want now?
So, who took the package? Raiders?
Sure. Assholes with guns. Kinda like they're... Are we done here?
What is this place?
If Edward wanted you to know, he'd have told you.
Mm-hmm. What is this package, anyway?
It's a metal case, holding vials of serum. What is it? I don't know and I don't care. They pay the bills, I just work here.
Nothing else.
Okay.
Talk to Maria, if you need it. Maria's in charge.
Hey, man. I don't think we've met, but your time is impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minutemen.
Minutemen?
We protect the people at a minute's notice. That's the idea, anyway. You might have heard we're making a comeback. The General sent me to collect donations from concerned citizens like yourself. Help us out, and you can count on the Minutemen to be there when you need us. Can I put you down for, say, 100 caps?
You're not present. Justin Garvey.
Say what, man?
You know what? It's charlatans like you that give the Minutemen a bad name.
Oh, shit.
Coward hides. position.
Good as done.
Come on.
Sure.
Hey.
Yeah? Open for business.
Imogene is missing, and I want her found.
She's not missing, Mother.
So did you find out what happened to the courier?
But that doesn't mean...
Your sister is missing, and I want her found. What else is Edward for, if not to keep the family safe?
Mother, Edward has better things to do than sending someone out to find Imogene. Again.
I don't think you're even listening to me, Jack.
I'm not going to have Edward drop everything just because Imogene decided to take a lover again.
Did you not offer?
How dare
what?
You speak so disrespectfully about your sister? I insist you send someone to find Imogene.
She's a grown woman. She's perfectly capable of looking after herself.
Imogene is out there somewhere, maybe even
there.
Yeah. Dead in a ditch.
Take your time.
Some raiders set up camp near Parsons and ambushed him. I took care of them.
I don't like raiders operating so close to Parsons. I hope this isn't the start of something serious. What about the serum he was carrying? Did you get any of it back?
What's so important about this serum?
You're getting paid to follow orders. Your orders were to get it back. That's all you need to worry about.
There was only this one vial left.
Oh, good. I was afraid we wouldn't get any of it back. Here's your pay for the job. I'm throwing in a little bonus for bringing back the serum. That was good work. Now, as far as what's next... Oh, hell. I guess it's time you met Wilhelmina. Jack's not gonna be happy about it. Come on.
I can't bear to think what might be happening to Imogene right now.
She's a grown woman. She's perfectly capable of looking after herself.
People can't actually live here, right?
I can't bear to think what might be happening to Imogene right now.
She's a grown woman.
Jack, I'll take care of it. Mrs. Cabot, don't worry. I'll send someone to find Imogene.
Thank you. I can always count on you. Why can't you be as devoted as dear Edward?
You shouldn't indulge her, Edward. It just makes her more impossible to deal with next time.
Just doing my job. Speaking of which, here's all we got back of the last delivery from Parsons. Raiders got the rest of it, I'm sorry to say.
Ah, good. Finally. This will help settle Mother down.
Imogene is Jack's sister. Probably figure that out yourself. She's, a little flighty. Impulsive. From time to time, she runs off. Usually with a new boyfriend. Then I send somebody to bring her home.
Do you know where she's gone?
No, but it shouldn't be too hard to find out. She's been spending a lot of time in Good Neighbor. That's a jazz club there, the third rail. Somebody there must know something. She's not known for keeping her mouth shut.
What if she doesn't want to come home?
Obviously, as one of the family, you can't just knock her in the head and drag her home by her heels. Usually, by the time I send someone after her, she's gotten bored with the whole thing and is ready to come home. I'm sure you'll think of something. You're supposed to be resourceful, remember?